So first of all, let's go over yesterday's choices. You told Kate to wait for more proof. You didn't answer Kate's call. You tried to shoot Frank. You saved Kate. Yay. And you blamed Mr. Jefferson in the minority. You watered your plant. You helped Alyssa. You erased the link to Kate's video. You were friendly with Taylor. You accepted Warren's invitation to go ape. You didn't write a message. You didn't tamper with the rail tracks. You gained entry to the Vortex Club party. You helped Warren. And you told on David to Mr. Jefferson. So let's go ahead and get started.
In the previous episodes of Life is Strange.
Oh, like yes.
Film Little Pieces of Time.
I'm so sick of people trying to control me!
Speakers. Don't ever touch me again, freak!
It totally makes sense. You hella saved my life.
Hopefully this doesn't interrupt anything, sorry.
I think it's awesome you set a tongue record on video.
You're going to be sorry someday.
And it did. But hey, pause, that's cool. I don't really know how to unpause it. Okay, there we go.
And there she is. How are you doing, Max?
Hi, Joyce. I am so sorry about William. I have great memories of him.
That was his gift to us. Wonderful memories.
Let's talk about your superpower.
Hey, Stelma and Louise. You're my business now.
That's Rachel's bracelet. Why the fuck are you wearing her bracelet?
You want me to cut you, bitch?
Please, step back.
You're kidding. Put that down.
Please, get me out of here! Max!
Nobody cares about me. Nobody. What are you doing here, Max?
Now, I know today was difficult for everybody. Miss Caulfield, why exactly were you on the route with Kate Marsh? Please, tell us everything.
What the hell is this?
Max, there was no eclipse scheduled today.
I believe you, Warren. I believe anything this week. I knew Chloe would be all over this, so I better get moving.
Alright, one sec, guys. I gotta take care of something real quick. All right. Ready to go.
Hey, Bunny. Kate will be back soon, and until then, I'll be catering to your every whim. Are you a hungry bunny? Here, nosh on this.
This game is the first time I've ever heard the word nosh.
There's been so much going on, I almost forgot about the eclipse. All this atmospheric action can't be a coincidence. And all roads are leading to my tornado vision. Oh, I'm sorry, Lisa. I saved Kate, but I drowned my own plant.
You watered the plant too much. You killed it. I can't believe you killed Lisa.
How did Sherlock Holmes deduce anything without the internet? Glad the media doesn't waste a second exploiting Kate. Now she has another video of herself all over the web. And even I'm in this one. Oh, at least the news didn't mention my name. Yet. Besides Rachel, it's been a while since anybody vanished from Arcadia Bay. I shouldn't sound so disappointed. I sure hope these people treat her better when she comes back to school. If she does.
Well, you did. Good job.
Man, I really turned a molehill into a mountain. I feel bad for Mr. Jefferson about this.
I can't believe you blamed Mr. Jefferson. He's just a teacher. Look at all these people. They're pissed.
Either I delete my page or I block everybody. Nowhere to hide these days.
Everyone's happy.
Everybody will be talking about Kate now. Blackwell might as well shut down for the next month.
Oh, oops.
Ew! Thanks for the image, Nathan. And everybody here thinks Samuel is a creeper?
Samuel's kinda weird.
It's amazing how happy Kate looks here compared to today. She was basically pushed up to that roof. And I will use my power to find out why. This has to end. You know you're hurting when you don't give a shit about music. No way can I clean that shit off. Time to get Samuel da Vinci to repaint. Jeebus, I am so freaking tired. I sound like a moron. But crime does not delay. I need to stay on top of this investigation. Kate's okay, Max. Take a breath. Get your shit together. You have time.
Oh yeah, there are, in between the episodes, there's usually SMSs, so I'm gonna go through those. That's what they showed at the end of the last episode. Oh god, we are really behind. I'm just showing off the art, really. Hey, Chloe, move your foot. It's not a good place for your foot. A twee loser.
Okay, this is scary dark. Let there be... That's a depressing thought. And it's always about Victoria. I hope you burn bright again soon, Kate. So much hypocrite. Do they really need that crap on the door? Kate's still alive.
Hey, Max. I saw you go up on the roof and save Kate. I can't believe she tried to jump.
Do we comfort her or do we blame her? It's all her fault, right?
I can. I'm just so glad she didn't. Are you okay?
I'm just, like, shocked. I've never seen anybody try to kill themselves before.
Me neither. I didn't think you'd be so upset considering how much shit you and Victoria gave Kate.
I'm my own person, not Victoria's bitch. Hello, like, she's freaking too. She already broke curfew tonight. Shit, I'm not supposed to tell anybody.
I won't say a word. I swear to dog.
I believe you, Max. Besides Victoria, you're the only one who asked me about my mom in the hospital. That meant a lot to me.
I'm my own person, too. Let me know if you need anything.
Thanks. You're like weird, but pretty cool, Max. Especially after watching you go up on that roof. Victoria's wrong about you. Now I have to be alone for my nightly anxiety attack. Talk to you later.
Rewind.
Max.
I know. Victoria must be upset since I saw her sneaking out of the dorm past curfew.
Oh man, like, you saw her? She was so, like, nervous when she left the dorm. She wouldn't even tell me where she was going.
Probably to hell. Well, I have to go crash. It's been a rough day, as you know.
Thanks, Max. And it was, like, pretty awesome when you went up to the roof to save Kate. Victoria was wrong about you. Now I have to be alone for my nightly anxiety attack. Talk to you later.
I hope Victoria feels particularly shitty about posting that link. Ugh, Cave Max want to shower, but no time. Must meet Chloe. Ugh, Victoria isn't here. Maybe I'll just wait and bide my time. Going through her shit. Since I've crossed the line from Snoop to Detective, I might as well search for clues about what really happened to Kate at the Vortex Club party. Victoria is about as street as me, but she really appreciates style. Those boots are made for walking runways. These socks cost more than my wardrobe. I'll title this one, Portrait de la Assholes. Whoa, there's Kate. Totally high. She looks confused, not like she's partying. Here they are getting loaded with Satan.
Take a picture of it yet.
That's a lot of bank just to clean paint from a sweater. Victoria's secret. She's a geek.
Squirrel looking at fireflies. Some fish. Cigarette equals death. A bird. Unknown. Bird. Two people. Ant and feather. And American flag.
There has to be some dirt in here on Victoria. Well, well. Victoria and Taylor actually show remorse. First Rachel and now Kate? This is the end of the Vortex Club. A unique point of view is right. Thanks to Courtney Wagner ghostwriting this paper. Whoa, I had no idea Victoria's parents owned the Chase space. Nothing to see here. I guess I shouldn't be so bummed. Not that Victoria couldn't hide her shit. Man, I'm getting paranoid.
Hey, Max?
Dana's really hurting over this. Dana looks guilty and relieved about Kate. She really does care. Hey, Dana. How are you doing?
Better than Kate. I just can't believe she would even attempt suicide.
I knew she was depressed, but I had no idea how bad.
Must be serious to throw yourself off the roof.
Kate was serious. But it's not all about that video.
So what exactly are you saying, Max? I know Jefferson got reamed by the principal. Do you think they're involved?
I'm not sure yet, but I'm on it. Weird shit is going down at Blackwell, and I'm going to find out why.
I'm getting scared now. But people here are still sneaking out tonight.
What? Like, who?
Victoria bounced out of here earlier, and now you, Sherlock?
Not me. I need a break from today. Get some sleep too, Dana. I'll see you later.
Liar. Liar, liar, pants on fire.
Dana clearly doesn't mind if I peruse her laptop. Aw, Trevor is a sweetie. Good for Dana.
Nice.
If Dana talks to Juliet about this, she's gonna wish she didn't. This is both sad and pathetic. So Chloe is waiting for me in front of the main hall.
Oh, no, you don't.
Look at the lens and say nut. Gotcha. The Tabanka does look pretty scary at night. Please don't destroy me. Maybe Samuel should fix that lamp.
No, we like dark, scary campuses.
I feel so giddy, even after Kate almost jumped. Maybe it's the leftover adrenaline. But I feel kind of invincible now.
Explore everything. Come on, Chloe.
Everywhere I go, I can see how I'm altering history. Big and small. Principal Wells. Are you serious? I'm toast if he sees me.
Nobody can expel me. Not yet, anyway.
Yeah, go look at the door again.
Max the Ninja strikes again.
Get it? Booyah. Like I'm a scary punk ghost.
More like a scary punk asshole. Hey, Chloe, I didn't exactly have the greatest day trying to keep my friend from jumping off the roof. I don't think I need you to prank me tonight, okay?
Sorry, but you absolutely balls to the walls did save your friend.
Kate saved herself. I couldn't even use my power. My head felt like it was being crushed. And then I had no clue what to say to her on that roof.
Don't be so modest, Rockstar. Kate is alive because of you. You obviously said the right thing, and your badass power is gonna save us all. We just need to connect the plays.
And find out who almost killed Kate. We have to stop this from happening to anybody else.
Oh yeah, and somehow stop that tornado from wiping out Arcadia Bay, right?
I hope so, Chloe. But how? Snow and eclipse are bad omens.
This whole town is a bad omen. And notice that Blackwell seems to be ground zero.
Chloe, I just feel weird about some of my decisions. Especially after I just got Mr. Jefferson in trouble.
Dude, do not even torture yourself like that. Let's focus on looking for clues, okay?
We need to find out more about who Rachel was involved with around here.
She was able to blend in with everybody, even with people I hated.
And even though I don't know her, it feels like Rachel is guiding us to the truth.
Fuck the truth. I just want to find my friend right now. It scares me to think where she could be. Do you think she's...
kicking it in Los Angeles? That would be the best case scenario.
She wouldn't leave without me, okay? And how often do missing girls turn up? We have to find Rachel soon. We have to.
I promise you we will. Like you said, it's time to start the search for clues. Now tell me, what's your secret?
Drumroll, please. I present the spare keys to Blackwell. Thank you, step prick.
You are such a boss, Chloe. I just don't want you to get into any more trouble.
Look at all the trouble dropping in Arcadia Bay. At this point, who gives a fuck anymore? We're in it to win it, Max. Lead the way.
I'm so glad you're my partner in crime.
As long as you're my partner in time.
Insert groan here. Thank you again so much for helping me put together a portfolio.
Hopefully the rest of the class will follow your lead. I'm sorry I was distracted. As you know, it's not been a good day for Blackwell.
I know this has been an awful day, and you can talk to me anytime, Mr. Jefferson.
Thank you, Victoria. I'm glad it had a relatively happy ending.
I don't know what I would have done if Katie jumped.
Katie? I had no idea you two were that close. Did she?
Well, how does this affect the Everyday Heroes contest?
The contest will go on. I just won't be representing Blackwell at the event this year, thanks to Max, who claims I enabled Kate Marsh's trouble by merely listening to her.
I'll give you a one-word sneak preview of Max's photo. Selfie. Listen, you've seen my entry. You know it's better than that. Wouldn't that be so cool to hang out together in San Francisco?
He's not going.
Stick to Mr. Jefferson, Victoria. I won't be going to San Francisco, remember?
You already love my work, so it's not like you're playing favorites. Just imagine if you picked my photo, though. We would have to spend a lot of time together. That could be fun, don't you think?
I'm going to think that you didn't say any of that.
You might as well choose me.
Otherwise, I might have to tell people you offered to choose my photo for favors or something.
Jeez.
As a favor to your future, I'll also ignore that undisguised threat. This conversation is officially over, Miss Chase. I suggest you go back to your dorm now.
Wait! I only... Are you fucking kidding me?
Notice.
When I think Victoria can't get any more evil. Shit is about to get real at Blackwell. Let's go find out. Chloe the Keymaster. You know it. Dude. I don't know about this. We're both already in so much trouble. You can always let me get busted like you did with the weed. I'm serious. We're not kids anymore. We're breaking and entering. If I have a key, how can it be breaking? They can't charge us for just entering. I'm serious. We could go to jail. Not if I'm related to the head of Blackwell Security. Stepshit will not want me in the hands of the local police. So we better find out what's in the principal's office first. You can rewind if we get caught, right? You have mad powers, Max. But my powers didn't save Kate. Maybe I did on my own. Come on, one more door and our work here is done.
Yeah, the school's a little bit more creepy at night.
A long time ago, in a girl's room right here. An A minus? All right, all right. So Dr. Max did help Warren this morning.
Should we change his grade?
Ass biology. Ugh, gross. A periodic table. Wish I knew what periodic means. Everybody's asleep. I hate to wake them up, but I want a picture. Good evening, Fish Fish. Thanks, Fish. Nice work.
Okay, we won't change the grade.
Please resume your slumber. I never said they were great, troll. Ew, gross. At least switch to E6. Oh, Kate. Even when you were sad, you tried to see the good in the world. Shit. Victoria. That is pretty fucking sweet. How can I hate somebody that shoots like that?
That's a good picture.
Daniel's a better illustrator than photographer. Said Max, the art critic.
That's a better picture than beard guy.
I say one stupid thing and Mr. Jefferson gets screwed.
Nice going, Max. I feel gross even looking at Nathan's work. But he does have some style. Victoria's cigarettes? I'm sure Mr. Jefferson is impressed. I'm so glad you still have your locker, Kate. There's no way David would get in Mrs. Grant's face. She'd shut his ass down fast. Only a total phony would wear a crappy hat like that.
Judgmental much?
I feel bad for the twee hipster who lost his beret. But Betty's cute.
Any day now, Max, or I'll just smoke a bowl and wait.
Yes, yes, Chloe.
Squirrels like nuts. Does that mean Samuel is... Nah.
Okay, let's talk.
That's it. What the fuck? The security officer should have the key to the principal's office.
He's hiding shit, like everybody here.
Well, now we definitely have to get this door open. Believe it or not, I know a little about lockpicking, thanks to Frank. I might as well test out my thief skill.
Go for it. We're already in this deep.
Well, you could look for the key. Just in case.
Why, yes, I could. Dead end. Here are the keys. None for the principal's office. Crap. Boring. No keys here. Dead end. Nothing here. No key for thee. We have to find another way in.
Guess I didn't spend enough time with Frank. But I'll use my DIY lockpick tools while you come up with a better plan.
My plan has a name. Hey, Warren, you busy? Just bubble hearth, you'll be okay. Listen, I need your physics expertise stat. Without naming names, if somebody had access to the art and science labs and wanted to construct a device that would, say, open a locked door, would you maybe kinda know how? Huh? No, I'm just asking for fun. Thanks, science guy. No, stay. We need you as backup. Just send the text instructions now. Yes, I'm still all in to go ape with you at the drive-in. Thanks for the help.
This sucks ass. Goddamn door. Try not to wake up everybody at Blackwell.
Sorry, Max. I got nothing. What about your plan?
I'm gonna go put it together. Can you stay here and not get caught?
I might get on the other side of that door before you, Lupin.
The race is on. See you soon.
Sugar, soda can, duct tape, and sodium chlorate. Get all the things, wrap up the can with the tape, and then put the stuff in it. Boom.
Sugar.
I know where all the things are, so...
Only three more items to go. Warren is such a classic nerd. Let's see if I can find those items. Okay, I have the can. You're halfway home, Max.
Do you hear that noise of my friend messaging me on... Oh god, it's really loud.
You're an artist, damn it, not a scientist. But this is so not sodium chlorate. Here's the sodium chlorate box. You know you're clumsy, Max. Don't waste your rewind power. Use the damn chair. Only one more ingredient left.
Next time I'll just log out of Battle.net app.
This is like a scene in a horror film. The tape is mine. Now it's time to show Chloe that Max is the bomb.
Ha 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 ha.
Take it easy on the door, Chloe. Let's try this instead.
Pipe bomb.
Boom! Literally. Yes! Time to blow shit up! If you'll light the candle. This is so cool!
Oh, man.
Get ready to haul ass. That was so fucking cool! Oh, we are toast! Here comes the whole Arcadia Bay Fire and Police Department. So what should we do?
Magic. Oh, look, the door. It's closed.
This ancient door is no match for Max the Magician.
If I can get this bastard open, she can't cheat with her rewind. Oh, this is bullshit! Fuck you, door!
Welcome to my domain. You are magic! I have no clue how the hell you got in there, but you did it, sister. The company I keep. Now, let's find what we want and beat it. My powers only go so far.
Man, I can see why the principal locks this room up. Fancy faux art crap. He must want everybody to know he has money, but no taste.
can you trust somebody who has a fucking bronze bird in his office? I'm glad I was expelled.
Yes, if only the principal had a Monet or Picasso, you'd still be at Blackwell.
Eat me. I'm gonna pilfer the papers on this ugly-ass desk. Okay, sure. It's ugly, but damn, is it a cozy chair. This is your chance to truly get all deductive and shit, Sherlock. Find us some clues about Rachel, or Kate, or Nathan. Anybody. I'm on the case.
Chloe, say hello to my little friend.
Say goodnight to the bad guy.
Dude, I know I shouldn't be going through the principal's files, but it's kind of cool.
Now's your chance to get revenge on Blackwell.
Oh yeah, I'm so bummed I don't get to party with the Vortex Club.
There's still time.
Especially with you around, right?
Don't talk. Search.
Oh, I like it when you get bossy. You're finally learning from the master.
You're not so tacky up close. That is so cool that my signature actually counted. Go, Miss Grant.
All right. No more new surveillance. Good job.
This pretty much sums up Kate. Shy and sweet. And in the wrong place. Only two more files to go. I certainly can't use this. Looks like an oil painting spill. Awful. Look at this pile. I guess being a bully is in the Prescott DNA.
God. His dad's worse than him.
Tumbleweeds. Weird. This asshole has a spotless record.
Nathan Prescott continues his family's historical legacy at Blackwell Academy with a stellar academic record in a variety of extracurricular activities, including work with the Arcadia Bay Homeless Fund. Nathan is popular among students and faculty. He stands as a proud representation of Blackwell. Yeah, screw you.
Like I'm not gonna read my own personal file.
Wow, your GPA sucks, Max. They call her nosy. She is very nosy. Despite some recent confrontations with Blackwell security, Max showed herself to represent the very best of Blackwell Academy by stopping fellow student Kate Marsh from jumping off the dormitory roof today. At this time, there is an ongoing police faculty investigation, but Max's heroism is undisputed. Yeah.
This file is going to be so spotless, I'll projectile vomit.
Look at that, 3.9. What is with these rich kids and their huge GPAs?
I have to make sure Warren doesn't have a criminal background. Let's nab this last file, Sherlock. Always wanted to say nab. Rachel doesn't seem so troubled based on all this. But there's not much here about the police investigation.
Wow. 4.0 GPA, okay. Just wanted to let you know that Rachel Amber's investigation has been officially closed on our end. We always hope for that one magic clue, but once again, Arcadia Bay covers up another secret. We always keep our eyes and ears open, but that's all we can do for now. Thanks for all your help, Lieutenant Chris Rossi, Arcadia Bay PD.
Man, I don't blame the principal for expelling Chloe. Bad Chloe.
Chloe does little homework and is often willfully belligerent to her teachers. She has caused numerous class disruptions with inappropriate comments and rude gestures to fellow students. She was recently suspended for spray painting graffiti in the parking lot. Even though Chloe is an intelligent student with potential, she chooses to squander it on empty rebellion against a non-mandatory institution. Chloe Bryce is no longer a student of Blackwell. Please see attached police reports.
I think we found everything in here. I should go join Chloe now. I'd drink too if I was the principal of Blackwell.
Max, you better come check out these files. Nathan accuses Rachel of bringing drugs on campus, and my step troll went along because he thinks Rachel was a bad influence on me. Assholes.
If David is teaming up with Nathan Prescott, that's a bad sign.
Nathan Prescott III. Ooh, he's so money. And you know the Prescotts dropped Major Bank to bury Nathan's real file. Look, it reads like a rap sheet. Bad grades, teacher complaints, secret probation. But I was expelled?
But what about
the Prescotts
double secret
always
probation?
Get their money's worth. Check out that note. Open it.
It's just some crazy drawing.
It's not a drawing. Look. Rachel in the dark room. Rachel in the dark room. Over and over. That's it.
That's fucked up. What does this even mean? Nathan is truly psychotic. I know he has something to do with Rachel missing.
Whoa, listen to this. David M. always asks what's going on in my head. David M. always helps me follow those he follows. It's pretty cryptic.
No, it sounds like they formed some sort of weird team, the Super Hebros.
Jesus. David was stalking Kate, hassling me, and now we know he was all over Rachel, too.
Oh, we are so going into his garage files. Plus, I'm getting a little paranoid in here. We got our info. Let's bail. But maybe we shouldn't leave without a gift.
No, you are not taking the cozy chair.
Max, do your powers include mind reading? Or did you just rewind because I tried to steal the chair? Shit, I'm confused.
It's the powers of best friendship. I know how you roll. We should definitely get out of here. We pressed our luck enough.
Hello, what have we here? Holy shit! Jackpot! Cha-ching!
Wow, sir. That's a lot for the handicapped fund.
Dude, there's $5,000 here. I could pay Frank back tonight. This will chill him out after you almost, you know, shot him. Are you gonna make a big issue out of this? Or just rewind and take the greenbacks for yourself. I hope you do that instead of lecturing me.
Oh, man. On one hand, if you take it, you can pay off Frank, and maybe he won't be so mad that you tried to shoot him. On the other hand, stealing is bad. Up to you. Steel.
Frank knows things about Rachel, and he might talk if he's been paid, right?
You are Supermax. And with the leftover dough, I'll take you on a road trip to Portland for the day. We'll stock up on tats, beer, weed, and donuts, and books from Powell's, and strip clubs. Kidding. But you never know.
I feel like shit for taking that money.
Rewind. I won't leave until you say yes or no. Chloe seems really happy.
That impish look scares me.
Care for a midnight swim? The Blackwell pool is ours.
Swimming? You want to take that risk now?
It's been a cray week. We deserve a little mindless fun in the water. We're done for the night anyway. We're rich, and nobody busted us. So? Splish splash?
Splish splash. You're right.
We hella deserve it. Splish splash.
Did you actually just say hella? I think I'm a good bad influence on you.
We're in the otter's lair.
Big fucking deal. I want that heated water.
We still have to play it cool, okay? I still go to school here.
You can own this hellhole once you figure out your rewind power.
Chloe is so psyched for girls' night out, so I better follow her evil plan. Go, otters. I would love a soda, but I'd just get wired. I actually don't have the time to investigate this caper. If only I could solve the mystery of the missing cat pics. I hope the otters will survive.
Boys or girls?
Boys or girls? You can explore either one, regardless of which one you choose.
Girls, of course.
Girls? Ooh la la.
Let me check to see if the pool's heated. Those are some musty-ass old shirts. Yuck. Those look like the most cozy, comfy towels in towel history. Want? Flippers in a swimming pool? Are they training Navy frogmen here? A bus ticket? Was she going to run away? Like Rachel Amber? The wit, it burns.
So, Victoria's secret is selfies. Go fuck your... No. Jefferson said, don't confuse art with the artist. These are cool shots. If I could rewind back to the 1940s, I'd get in serious trouble. Looks like Brooke wants to go to the drive-in with Warren.
Too bad we are.
Where does that other sock go? I hope so, friend. Well, we care, dickhead. Sorry, Rachel. Ooh, pink goo. I see why everybody brings their own soap. Hello, gorgeous. You wish, Max. You just look like a snoop. This isn't a desperate cry for attention or anything. Looks like I'm the Vortex Club bouncer.
Well,
decisions, decisions.
Do we remove names from the list?
Bros will be bros. Max Caulfield. Moral Avenger, or self-righteous hypocrite. This one is almost empty. The guys must like their pink goo.
God.
Huh, it's nice to know Victoria loves something besides herself. Welcome to 1950. I bet you do.
You haven't answered yet. Do we remove names from the list?
Sometimes.
No, okay.
I guess I should consider this evolution. I guess somebody forgot their Blackwell spirit. Some poor hipster lost their vape. It's okay for Nathan to be hooked on these drugs, right? This must be for training kids. Zach is really careless. Doesn't he know what happens when I'm around?
I guess that's the sext that they were talking about, when Juliet was talking about.
No way am I touching Zach's jersey. Betty developed that in Jefferson's class. But why?
Oh gee, I wonder.
Boys' locker room is right. Huh,
Chloe just couldn't wait to splish splash in the pool.
Max, try to find the light for the pool. I want to see the sharks.
Otters don't like sharks. They bite.
So do I. Hit that light.
In case I run out of air, I know where to come. There has to be a control panel for the lights around here. Aw, look at the baby Halloween pumpkin. Coffee and swimming. Good combo. Yes, we get it. Otters. Don't even think I'm gonna make a move on you. Now I have the power over light and death. So, the big plan is... win.
Push.
Time to do or dive, Max.
Oh yeah, baby. Feels like a hot tub. And with my cash dash, I'm queen of the world. Bow. Tell me you're not gonna stand there watching me like a zombie. Don't you dare! Come stop me, hippie. Okay, you asked for it. Cowabunga! Why, look, an otter in my water. Dun 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 dun. You are so obvious. And I still get freaked out by that movie, so stop. I can't even watch any of those shark shows. I'll just rewind and harpoon you. Otter's revenge.
Cheater.
Yeah, you wouldn't know about that.
I wish Rachel was here. She would totally love being in here at night. Wish you guys had met each other.
We will. With all this stuff going on, I'm starting to think everything is related.
And I want to find out for Kate's sake. She almost died today.
Your power is changing everything, Max. Especially you. I can already tell. You're not so chicken shit anymore.
Thanks, girlfriend.
You know what I mean. You're becoming like this force of nature.
More like luck of nature. Come on, my power failed trying to rescue Kate. Maybe I'm just stumbling back and forth in time. For what reason?
You didn't stumble when you saved me, Max.
Not that time. But that's because you were there to kickstart my power.
So it's time to start moving forward in time. And we're obviously connected, since without me, you would have never discovered your power, right?
Absolutely. You make me feel like I know what I'm doing.
And you make me feel like I have a reason for still being in Arcadia Bay.
I hope so.
Stop being so goddamn humble. You're like the smartest, most talented person I've ever known.
More than Rachel Amber?
Dude, I'm not her groupie, okay? And I'm sure you have Blackwell bros all over you. Like Warren.
Up to you here.
Warren is nice.
Nice? Ouch. That means friend zone.
No, he's really cool. It was so sweet when he stood up to Nathan. But I haven't told him about my rewind power.
No worries. Once you get over yourself, you're gonna make the world bow.
As long as you're there with me.
Don't look so sad. I'm never leaving you.
Now I'm getting cold in here.
Because we're yapping instead of attacking each other, otter versus shark style. I think I've had my pool experience for the year. Let's jet.
Let's call it a draw. I'm gonna freeze my ass off when I get out. Gross. I feel like we just went swimming in Chlorine Bay.
You look cute with your hair soaked in chemicals.
Thanks. You would know.
Hide!
Make sure you come over.
Are you shitting me? Like when we were kids.
I could use my power, or just look for a hiding spot, or both.
Where are they? Hey!
Oh, shit.
Where are they? Hello?
Your salad.
Hello? Anybody there? Better not try any Halloween pranks after today. I'm serious. I heard something over here.
We are so invisible.
Let's bail.
Wait, turn around. They're coming. We have to find another way out.
Oh, this is bullshit. You can't go back to your dorm now. You're a Blackwell fugitive. Crash at my place tonight.
You want me to crash where the Blackwell security officer lives so I'll be safe?
Okay. Into the car. Get in. Later, fuckers. Max, you rock. We are so fucking awesome.
Yes, we so are.
Time for more good music.
always remember this moment.
Photobomb!
Photo hog. It feels like a different world from yesterday.
We left a skid mark on Blackwell last night.
Like it needs another one. I'd like to do something good for my school in Arcadia Bay. I can't even submit my photo to represent. I just don't want to be rejected.
Every great artist gets rejected before they get accepted. So you have to enter a photo.
Even though I'm pimping the school in town you want to torch?
Come on, I don't want to see Arcadia Bay burn to the shore. I just say shit like that because I've been trying to get out of here since you left, basically. If I could find Rachel, then pay Frank off, I'm still leaving to start a whole new life.
Wish we could just hang out all morning like we used to. Maybe we should get up. I have to get back to Blackwell soon.
Oh, does the schoolgirl have a test today?
I'm starting to feel like going to Blackwell every day is a test. I just need to get on my regular school schedule again.
I know that it is freezing, but I think we have to walk.
It's a good song.
I keep waving at the taxis, they keep turning their lights off.
I'm so wiped out from last night. But it was awesome.
I have to ponder what kind of criminal I've become.
Last night was only the tip of the iceberg.
I have to admit, it was pretty cool to take over the Blackwell Gym.
Today the gym, tomorrow the world. We need to step it up.
We still have to be careful how I use my power. I don't want to get stuck in time.
Sidewalk and the pigeons in my window reflection. The mask I polish in the evening by the morning looks like shit. And I know you have a heavy heart. I can feel it when we kiss. So many men stronger than me have thrown their backs out trying to live.
Okay, I need to get dressed now. Chloe seems more relaxed now that she has that money from the handicapped fund.
I love this morning light. It's so peaceful.
Wouldn't it be wicked if we could just hang out here forever like when we were kids?
Yes, but sadly we're not kids anymore.
At least you can date now, right? My dad was terrified of the day I would discover boys.
So, you never really told me if you had a serious boyfriend while I was away.
Not serious. Hella stupid, usually. I went through a boy toy phase, among other things.
I can't see you with any of the guys around here.
Because you have a good eye. That's why I was so glad Rachel came along to rescue me.
Sounds like you totally crushed on Rachel.
You would have too. Smart, sexy, and sassy. Like me, right?
Well, duh. Maybe Rachel would have fought over both of us.
You wish. Then again, maybe. You're a photographer and she wanted to be a model.
Frank might think twice about messing with Chloe now, but if David finds out, shitstorm.
Nice. Chloe put my pic on her phone. I must have proved I was worthy again.
Jesus. Now I am glad Chloe took that money. This guy is serious and scary.
Seasons all have run away, but the feeling never
time to put on your daily armor, Max.
It
I was such a wuss to cower in the closet while David hit her.
Yeah.
Chloe is so damn cute. She's really trying to suss out what my vision means. Can I check out the news on this old laptop? Oh, at least we haven't been identified. Yet. Thank God she's okay. I wonder when I can visit her. It was so simple in the moonlight, so simple in the moonlight, so
simple in the moonlight.
I love this song.
Which one? What are we playing? Bright Eyes was the one that was just playing. Sparkle Horse is a bit more upbeat, like rock song, and Angus and Julia Stone is kind of like the one we were just listening to. It's nice and peaceful.
That was my 10th birthday. I didn't know Chloe kept this stuff. The fact that she put the photo next to Rachel's is so touching. Wow, I remember this old phone. We decorated it together. Yes, I might go to hell for this, but if it saves Chloe, we'll pay it back. Somehow. I don't think I'll be moshing today. I still feel guilty for not busting out of here to stop David from hitting Chloe.
Yeah. Wow, they really guilt trip you with that one. I've never done that before.
Ugh, still reeks like a chlorine factory.
See if you can find a suitable outfit in my fashion hole.
Okay, time for some Chloe cosplay.
Hey, there you go. Rachel left a bunch of her clothes with me. She's your size.
But not quite my style.
Max, you don't have a style yet. At least give it a try. You can always rewind back to your chlorine brand t-shirt and generic jeans.
You suck. I like my shirt and jeans. But it would be cool to try on Rachel's clothes just to see if they fit.
Stop second-guessing yourself, Max. Put this on and let your inner punk rock girl come out. You can afford to take chances whenever and whatever you want to try. For example, I dare you to kiss me.
What?
I double dare you. Kiss me now.
Boom. Major decision. Let your inner punk rock girl come out.
Damn, you're hardcore, Max. Now I can text Warren and tell him he doesn't stand a chance. Unless he's into girl-on-girl action.
You're such a dork. can't. That was priceless when I kissed Chloe. She didn't think I would. I think Rachel's style is a little more subtle. Like me.
Looking sick, Max. A couple tats, some piercings, and we'll make a thrasher out of you yet.
Ready for the mosh pit, Shaka Bra.
Oh, God.
Maybe not. Go on down and say hi to Joyce. Free breakfast. I have to, wake and bake first.
I promise not to tell.
Let's not rewind and find out, okay? Check you out, Max. Ready for the runway. Go downstairs and show Joyce. She'll love it.
Oh my god, that smells so amazing. It's like when we were kids here. Nobody in this town has a fucking clue as to what's happening. Do they? For everybody else in the neighborhood, it's just another morning. I better not go in there. David might be in bed. Ew.
There's a bird.
Check out Mad Max, ready to fucking thrash. I'm so hardcore.
Oh God, just stop.
No way. That's the bluebird I saved Monday in Joyce's room. Chloe has had this damn dirty pirate towel since we were kids. Serious flashback. Chloe never used to care when I borrowed her toothbrush.
Well, then she won't care.
What's ironic is I always hated it when Chloe used my toothbrush. It feels so good to wash my face after all that chlorine. And hiding. You know, I haven't gone through a dyeing my hair blue phase yet. Maybe it's time.
Max would look weird with blue hair.
This might be the one time these people are right. Looks like a message.
David, this is Officer Korn. Just want to let you know, your stepdaughter's car was identified near the black...
No.
Message deleted.
Oops. I hope that message wasn't for Joyce or Chloe.
It wasn't. Nope.
Wowza. Chloe still eats the same cereal. So do I. Joyce looks so different in her street clothes. I love that they still have the same refrigerator. Who drinks beer this early around here? Oh man,
I don't want to be famous for this.
Superheroine saves suicidal Blackwell student. Dead birds on the ground.
Three dead birds lined up? That's fucking ominous. I wonder how these birds died. Oh, dead bird. Poor thing.
That's not creepy at all.
Sitting in a swing always feels so comforting.
Then let's sit.
I remember when Chloe and me would take turns in the swing. We would push each other so hard we'd fly way up in the air. Chloe always wanted to swing all the way around. I always got scared and would jump off before I flew off. And Chloe is still trying to get high.
I like the music during those.
Joyce looks so different in her street clothes. Good morning, Joyce.
Rachel. Max. Oh, you startled me. Well, you fit those clothes well. Thank God you're not a hellraiser like her or Chloe. Now tell me exactly what you want to chow on.
Big decision. Biggest decision in the whole episode. Eggs and bacon.
Eggs and bacon all the way.
Remember when you guys would sleep in until I yelled out, wakey wakey, eggs and bakey.
Totally. We'd wake up so fast.
So this time you can help me with the ingredients. I need you to grab me the actual eggs and the bacon.
Okay.
I can handle eggs and bacon. I should evolve and become a vegan, but... Oh, bacon.
It took me so long to find the eggs. I'm like, who puts eggs outside of the refrigerator the first time I went through this?
The eggs always come first, as Joyce used to say.
Thanks. After all these years and everything that's happened, it's great to see you and Chloe together again. She hasn't had a good friend since you or Rachel. Oh, those clothes remind me so much of her. Such a sweet girl. I'm just hoping she's living large in L.A.
I'd love to think that too, Joyce, but...
We are on the same page, Max. I keep hoping that Rachel will show up or even send a message to Chloe from Hollywood. Or wherever she is.
I hate to even think this, much less say it out loud, but I think Rachel is in serious trouble.
I know. I watch those awful true crime shows, and it makes me ill if I think about Rachel ending up on one. So I don't think too much.
I see why Chloe is so obsessed with finding her.
Max Caulfield, are you actually jealous of Rachel?
Maybe. Rachel was so much cooler than me.
You think? Then why has Chloe been telling me she wishes she could be more like you over the past 5 years?
Doubt it. Did she really? 5 years ago feels like 1,000 now.
And that makes me what, a century old? You're only 18, Max. Oh, youth.
I like Joyce.
Only I could go back.
It's not all that, Joyce.
Voila, a breakfast fit for us queens. And a king. Go sit at the table.
I guess nobody waters the plant here. I'm glad that's creamy and not crunchy. Thank you so much, Joyce. I'm never leaving this table.
Good, you can clean.
Bring those eggs and bacon to my belly.
Do you need a knife for eggs and bacon?
Bring those eggs and bacon to my belly.
You ate almost all of it, though.
Seeing you again? Ah, made me remember so much. I know these photos don't measure up to your work, Max.
My favorite photographers probably take pictures similar to yours. You make David happy, Joyce.
He wants us all to be happy, Max. He's just not great at showing it.
No, he's not at all.
I don't think I can rock this outfit like Rachel.
You have your own cool style.
I totally remember that day.
I'm glad. William took this picture with his instant camera. Oh, it was the last picture he ever took. He had his car out right after this, and...
I know, Joyce. I'm sorry.
I didn't show you this to be morbid. In fact, I want you to have this. This was when my baby was so full of life and light. She was hopeful, positive. Everything she's not today. And this was the last time I ever saw Chloe truly happy.
Did you guys have a bonding session about how fucked up I am?
It's not always about you.
Chloe, please. It's too early to start picking a fight. Eat instead.
I'll keep the warden busy while you go peek in the garage.
Now stop whispering, or I'll know you're talking about me.
Stop being so nosy, Mother. Jeez, I can't do anything around here without everybody getting up in my shit.
Oh, no one can even joke with you, Chloe. You fly off the handle like that.
Excuse me, I have to use the bathroom.
Sure, run off and pee when you should back me up.
Now who's being paranoid? Just listen to yourself.
Nobody else does.
Do-do-do.
I do need to get into David's computer. He's gotta be hiding shit. I bet David has all of his surveillance secrets in his laptop. No shit, it needs a password. How about step douche? Try again.
Yeah, of course.
I need more clues. Nothing in it.
You know, except for surveillance stuff.
Naturally, David would buy a heavy-duty military padlock. I can even see the combination. That might be a useful password. No There's no way Chloe can put that gun back now. Huh. Maybe this ID number might work. I could try the license number for the password. Looks like David has read this a lot. What did he learn? David has been dragging his head around since 2001? Obviously, David's parents care about him. That date might be a good password. Cute. Can't picture David driving Joyce around with this on the car. That's cute. Could be a password here. Even David Madsen might be an angel to somebody else. Now the car looks ready to roll. This is a better hobby for David than surveillance. Joyce might as well have wrote, "Let's get married."
No emoji.
That might be a useful password. Maybe I could try stepdad for the password. Nothing to see here.
So, a lot of options here. This is quote unquote busy work, so I'm just gonna kinda skip it. But, you know, it actually shows that he cares about his family. It's the receipt date from when he first met Joyce.
Score! Max the Hacker strikes again. Whoa, spoiler alert. Rachel definitely hooked up with Frank. But why does David care?
So apparently Rachel Amber was picked up by the police for carrying drugs.
Instead of stalking Kate, David could have helped her.
Overheard Kate and Dana talking about supplies for Vortex Club. Drugs! Watch Kate in her church group. She knows her Bible. Kate stays in the bathroom longer than any other students. Drugs! Saw Kate helping Jefferson after class. Don't trust grown men with goatees. Kate has kept to herself since Vortex Club party. Not even church. Drugs! Tried to talk to Kate about the party. She got upset and ran. Guilty. God, this guy's a douche.
This is so wrong. Ugh, creepy bastard.
Mad Max, Max Factor, Noir Angel? I've never heard her referred to as that, and I've played this game quite a bit.
I better tell Chloe about this now. It's just one more thing to make her sad. And mad.
Let's pretend we didn't unlock his laptop. Boom. See? Didn't unlock the laptop. Look at that. See? You were nice to her, and she's all nice to you now.
Oh, I should know that Chloe can't get through an hour without creating drama.
Uh-oh. Step douche.
Nice breakfast.
David, you back already?
I have to take a nap after writing up vandalism reports last night.
What happened?
Some little shit-ass punks broke into the swimming pool. This is what happens at these PC bullshit colleges. Entitled students taking over the campus.
We didn't graffiti
or anything.
Do you
know for sure it was black whale students?
Who else would do it? And I'm gonna bust them. Figures you'd be here. Is that your Rachel Amber Halloween costume?
You know more about her than me.
No. You and Chloe think you know more than anybody. Like all teenagers.
Leave Max alone, David. Stop threatening students.
He threatens them with surveillance cameras so he can spy on everybody. Like he spies on all of us here.
Don't start, Chloe. Not now.
Yeah, I'm just always starting shit, right? You're a total paranoid, David.
Not now, Chloe.
He used to call me a loser for getting kicked out of Blackwell. So who's the loser now, David? Who haven't you accused or harassed? Between your investigations into Rachel and Kate, what have you done besides get in trouble?
Oh, decision. Do you side with Step Douche or with Chloe? He has been pretty bad stalking students, but maybe he has a reason? I don't know.
You're a bully, David. I saw you harass Kate Marsh when she was going through hell. You could have totally helped her. Everybody at Blackwell is a suspect to you, except for Nathan Prescott. That's why the students and faculty don't like you. You even hit your stepdaughter.
Yeah, screw
I do
you.
Respect your service, but you don't respect anybody.
Chloe was doing drugs. That's illegal.
So is spying on people in your family and at your work. Why do you have photos of Kate Marsh and Rachel Amber in your files anyway?
What? Is this true, Max? Yes, David. Why do you have these files at all? I find this very disturbing.
I do not have to take this kind of interrogation. Not from you punks.
Maybe you should calm down.
Oh, you're turning on me now, huh? Of course. Women always stick together. Well, screw you.
David! You better go to a hotel until we figure this out.
You can't kick me out of my own home.
It's my home, David. Paid for and in my name. You know the law, right?
Oh, I thought I knew a lot of things. Like when I'm outflanked.
Have a nice day.
Chloe, for once, just please shut up.
I hope Joyce doesn't hate me for tearing into David.
Keep or rewind?
I don't want to see or hear you again, Max. You've hurt me and my family enough.
Max, don't beat yourself up. David earned this all by himself. Understand?
Max, that gave me chills. And you better not rewind this one.
Listen, when I went through David's laptop, I found pictures of Rachel and Frank. Being
more than friends.
Right, no way, Max. She was just posing to tease Frank.
If you're not gonna believe me, why don't we check out what Frank has in his RV?
What's that gonna prove?
Frank has Rachel's bracelet. What else does he have in there?
Motherfucker better not have anything, for his sake. Let's check the door. Frank gets so wasted, he sometimes forgets to lock it.
What is he eating? Gross.
I can't believe you hung out with him.
Not anymore. We have to be casual ninjas here. Shitballs. Okay, here's the plan. I'll go to the diner and distract Frank by telling him I have his money, but he needs to come with me. Then you come in and rewind so Frank doesn't see me. Then you can tell Frank he needs to check out his RV, and then you rewind after you get the key, and...
Chloe, I got this. I'll be right back.
Don't let my epic plan get in the way of yours. I'll try to scrounge up a Scooby snack to distract his mangy mutt.
Now to find a quick and easy way to snag Frank's keys. Careful, Max. Cujo ahead. Locked.
What the hell is this?
I hope she finds a nice T-bone to keep the doggy busy. What is going on here?
Darn it. I think I missed a picture. Ugh.
This is so creepy.
XOXO.
Good morning. How are the fish today?
Don't ask. First the snow, then an eclipse. What's next, a tornado?
I hope not.
Could be worse. We could get one of those California quakes.
True. Well, I'm feeling a little dizzy now. Hope you catch the big one today.
I better. Too late to switch careers now. See you around, kid.
I'd love to do a whole big rig photo series.
Hey, no photo girl.
Oh, okay.
That would be cool to be a trucker for a while. Always on the road.
Hey, how's it going?
Peachy. Interview over.
Having a bad day at the office?
Work is dried up around here, and I have bills to pay. Time is money to a guy like me.
That sucks.
Wish I could drive right out of Arcadia Bay. Whole town is crumbling. Snow, eclipse, and a slut trying to commit suicide.
Oh, no you didn't.
Maybe you should leave then.
What if I could? Hell, even that shifty Rachel What's-Her-Face asked me once if I'd drive her to Los Angeles.
You knew Rachel Amber? Can you tell me about her?
Nope. Christ, why don't you get a real job instead of homework? I'd love to see you Blackwell turds try to drive my 1977 Needham 18-wheeler out there. Like I said, interview over.
It's ruined.
Hey, how's it going?
Peachy, interview over.
Actually, I wanted to ask if that's your bitch in 1977 Needham 18-wheeler out there.
How the hell did you know that?
My friend Rachel Amber told me about this cool rig in town because I love taking pictures of truckers.
You knew Rachel? She sure didn't give a rat's ass about truckers or real work.
Oh, so you must have known her too?
Only from the diner.
She was just a gold digger. She belonged in California with all those, you know, who know what's. Good riddance. But you can take pictures of my truck anytime. Take care.
I broke his hard outer shell.
Oh God, that is so embarrassing. I'm gonna get trolled hard.
Look at that. So sad and disturbing and beautiful at once. What an amazing shot. So ominous.
Yep, I missed the bird shot. It was on top of the thing in the living room. Darn it.
I hate seeing old women on the street like that. Nice world.
Hi, how are you?
I remember you.
Max, can I get you something from the diner?
I heard about that girl almost jumping off the Blackwell roof.
I think it's all connected to Rachel Amber's disappearance.
A lot of things in Arcadia Bay are connected to Rachel.
Frank Bowers knew Rachel. Have you seen him around?
I saw him today, looking more jumpy than usual.
I don't know how he hasn't been arrested yet.
Sounds like you know a lot more than me, child.
I just think Arcadia Bay is in trouble.
Maybe you'd like to tell me what you're hiding.
Oh man, decisions, decisions.
I feel like I can trust you as much as Chloe. And you wouldn't think I'm crazy.
Too late for me to judge anybody. Plus, you're not crazy.
I'm just gonna say this. I had a vision of Arcadia Bay being destroyed by a tornado. For real.
Could be. Bad mojo is in the air this week. Thanks for the warning, Max.
Good Lord, bacon. I'm ready to nosh again. Ugh, but I need to get those keys from Frank. That will be fun to take a road trip to the drive-in with Warren. Max needs more fun. Turn up the brain to 11, Max. How can you snag Frank's keys?
You show up after almost shooting me? You have serious balls, little girl. But hanging out with Chloe, playing with guns, and dressing like Rachel doesn't make you cool or tough. The fuck do you want?
How do you know these are Rachel's clothes?
Because she looks beautiful in them and you look like ass. Aiming a gun doesn't make you any sexier.
Grab your keys and let's check out your RV.
Let's not. You fucking creep me out.
In other words, Max, no keys. Maybe I could chat up that officer, or even Nathan, and then go all Groundhog Day on them until I get the info I need. Frank Bauer stars in A Faceful of Beans.
I love this.
You eat like a pig. Try the floor.
I was eating those beans. Are you fucking insane? I was eating those beans!
I could chug this beer, or dump it on Frank. Beer is gross, so...
Spell!
I just wanted to see what would happen if I did this.
I'm gonna kill you!
See, that's how you have fun with the power.
Never mind me, officer. I'm just here to steal a drug dealer's keys. Can't drop any tunes right now. Keys.
That's what you spent your $1 million on, Mr. I won the lottery? Some burnt toast thing? I don't know what those are.
Nathan and Frank together? That's a bad combo.
Rachel! Whatever the fuck. Oh, look, Max Amber. Is that your punk rock girl outfit? That was classic watching you turn on your everyday hero Jefferson yesterday.
Considering we're in a public diner with a police officer right over there, you shouldn't advertise your rage, Prescott.
No worries, because you're the one trying to fake it till you make it. At least you were smart enough to keep your big mouth shut in the principal's office.
I bet you hoped that Kate Marsh would stay quiet.
Idiot says what?
Did you drug her?
You are so stupid, Max. You think you're so goddamn smart, too. Don't push me, girl. You don't want me for an enemy, understand? Do you?
Calm down, dude. We're in the diner.
Right. Plus, you're an adult now. I can sue your dumbass for libel. Thanks. Now fuck off, Dyke.
Damn.
Holy shit, what do you want now?
Your sugar daddy will always protect you and threaten me.
You don't know shit about my father or me. Nobody here does.
Then tell me what I should know.
Why? So you can pretend to care, hmm? Spoiler alert, he's an asshole.
Maybe I could help you.
I don't need you for anything except to stay out of my fucking business, understand? Now get out of my face.
He's a very angry individual.
Holy shit, what do you want now?
I bet Frank hooked you and Rachel Amber up with party supplies.
Nice try. Rachel partied like a fiend on her own. More than me.
I doubt that.
Like you would know, virgin. Even that pig over there knows Rachel hung out more with Frank. I mean, don't talk to the cop about that, dumbass.
Try interrogating somebody else, Lieutenant Caulfield.
Holy shit, what do you want now?
Listen, Nathan. I'll take back everything I said about you. If you hook me up with Frank. Know what I mean?
You look like you've never even taken a hit of baby aspirin.
How do you think I stay wired all night studying? So is it a deal or not?
Calm down, hard up. Deal. You'll get your school supplies, just go over to Frank and whisper, higher education. You'll hook your ass up.
Wow, okay.
Holy shit, what do you want now?
Nothing.
There she is, Super Maxine.
That's your new nickname around the bay.
Yeah.
Sorry, but you did earn it. We're all real proud of you for helping Kate down.
Thanks, Officer Barry. I was just lucky. And right on time. Kate is who counts.
I'm glad you're representing Blackwell Academy.
I guess Kate Marsh will be the face of Blackwell for a while.
And you for helping her. That's the kind of school spirit we need more of.
I feel like David Madsen represents Blackwell.
Not for long. He's a loose cannon. We all respect him for his service, but he's too eager.
He's eager to be a dick to me and Chloe.
That's true. He was ranting about a stolen gun, then I tuned out. Somebody's always out to get him.
He's paranoid.
What can I do for you, Max?
I thought Nathan Prescott represents Blackwell.
Well, don't make me backwash this bacon. You know what the Prescotts represent.
Taking over Arcadia Bay?
You're not far wrong, Max. I heard the Prescotts are working on some new big land deals. Mr. Prescott helped out my family once a while ago. So I made a deal with him that I can't seem to get out of. Man, if I could get one instant replay in life. I better finish my breakfast first.
More info.
We'll chat later, Max.
No, we'll chat later.
I shouldn't have said that. I'll need to rewind.
What can I do for you, Max?
Well, I heard a rumor you were working for the Prescott family on the side.
Jesus, doesn't this town ever shut up?
Yes, I don't blame you for getting extra work.
Look, sometimes I check up on the Prescott family to make sure they're doing all right. Nathan included. Keep this quiet, Max. What can I do for you, Max?
Do you think Arcadia Bay is a weird town?
I'd take a normal city with normal problems about now. Makes me sick thinking about it.
Nathan said that Rachel Amber represents Blackwell. With Frank Bowers.
Bowers ain't no student anymore. Sadly, he does represent one side of Arcadia Bay. I want you to stay out of his orbit, okay? Him and that rabid mutt.
I heard something about Frank Bowers and his puppy. My boy does love his dog.
Especially when the dog is your personal drooling bodyguard. You can bet he trained that poor thing on blood.
Gross. I wouldn't bet. Where did he get the pup?
Frank used to bet on dog fights. Now, to his credit, he had a revelation. He saved a bunch of the dogs.
Oh, that's nice.
Kept one for himself. He's still a creep. You and that Chloe stay away, right?
Holy shit, what do you want now?
I heard your dad hired a local cop to keep an eye out on you and Frank Bowers. Like a babysitter.
Bullshit! My dad doesn't hire, he owns. And these pigs know better than to narc on me.
Do they? I hope that means Frank won't get busted.
Eventually he will. Guy's into some freaky shit. He told me once he took a weird blood oath for Rachel. Forget I told you that. Seriously. Now get off my crack, whore. Keep your pie holes shut.
God, this guy.
Holy shit.
Weren't you supposed to keep your mouth shut about the blood oath Frank took for Rachel?
Blood oath? Who? What the fuck? I never told anybody about that freaky shit. Besides, everybody knows Frank is a liar and a loser. Even Rachel did.
Yet Rachel Amber hung out with him more than you.
So? Rachel wanted Frank's stash. She let him take pictures, then he carries around her photo like she posed for love. Dumbass.
What the fuck now?
By the way, Frank, I was wondering if you had any, higher education.
Oh, yeah, sure. Do you want the after-school special to go with that? Jesus. Look, I don't sell anything but bottles to feed me and my dog. I work for a living. Not like you spoiled Blackwell punks with too much time on your hands. But nothing. Don't ever ask me for anything ever again. Ever. Now back off.
Well, that didn't work.
What the fuck now?
You know I saw that photo Rachel gave you.
How do you know about that? Huh? Chloe, right?
She just told me that one of Rachel's favorite pictures was the one she did for you.
Really? Yeah, I mean, that's what I thought. She was just a natural beauty, you know? Wait, let me find it. Here, judge for yourself.
I can't look at the picture? Oh, okay.
The magic keys to Frank's RV kingdom. I'm afraid I'll have to take your keys now, asshole.
You did not just do that. Give me back my keys, bitch. Give me my keys now.
I'm good at this whole rewind thing.
Key brought. Now back to Chloe.
Oh, where'd your keys go? Sorry. Oh, it's Alyssa.
Max?
Whew. That was close, Alyssa.
Okay, Max. This is the third time you've saved me from harm's way. You must be my angel.
Don't thank me. I haven't done anything special.
You've paid your dues by saving Kate's life on the roof. You really are a Blackwell hero, Max.
I'm just glad she came down. Kate's a good person, my friend. And she was almost bullied to death by a video.
It's fucked up, but you're an amazing friend. I want to make sure she knows how many friends she really has from now on.
Amen to that.
Max, we should get a posse to see her in the hospital when they allow visitors. Let's hang later and talk some more.
Nice Scooby snack, Chloe.
I should have known. The amazing Spider-Max.
I couldn't have done it without Frank. Now let's get in and out.
You'll need this, Max. On your mark, get set. Throw!
Oh, big decision. Towards the road or the parking lot?
Get the treat, treat boy!
I think we just made that dog our bitch. Get it?
Now we can snoop in peace. But let's not waste time. The doggy is busy now, but he might come back.
Damn, I thought my room was a shithole.
You're not a creepy drug dealer.
Frank has issues, but he's not creepy. At least I didn't think so until I saw him with Rachel's bracelet. Oh, we could cruise everywhere in this bad boy! Can you see us heading down the coast to Big Sur and beyond?
Yes, we'd be tearing up the highway. And you'd probably want me to kiss you again. Chloe, we're on a schedule. We need clues about Rachel.
I know. Just daydreaming. You scope the area while I hack his computer for info.
Frank is almost a made-for-TV hoarder. This place is nasty. Can't quite picture Frank and Chloe drinking beer and hanging out. I think the doggy likes his bone more. Frank must have a reason to keep a police radar nearby. That would be so cool to take this baby on the road with Chloe.
Crappy Wi-Fi out here. Must take him days to download porn.
Yuck. Zip, nada, nothing. The archetypal filthy guy dishes. I doubt Frank is trying out for the Arcadia Bay Brewers. Good to know Frank has a knife lying around. Of course Frank gets the munchies.
Whoa, what the hell is he doing with that dog?
Stop it. Frank must spend all his drug money on baggies. Recycle, dude. Nice rig. Glad Frank treats something here with respect. How can somebody live like this?
Who puts their stuff in the sink? Like, what? Oh, I guess when he's driving, he doesn't want it flying everywhere. I guess that makes sense.
Are these for Frank, or is he selling them? Or both? Too bad I don't have my Frank Bowers decoder ring. That's a pretty extreme lighter. Is Frank going to deal online now? That's almost cute to see Frank posing with his dog. Ooh, Frank's stash. No more secrets. Okay, this vent is loose. I need something to pry it open. Chloe isn't scared. She's loving this. This is almost as good as a set of keys. My blade will open any portal. Oh man, Rachel and Frank's dog. I don't know if I should be touched or disturbed.
She really liked Frank.
I'm glad Rachel got to drive this beast. She looks genuinely happy. Rachel really did hang out with Frank. I'm learning more about Rachel than I want to know.
Trouble in paradise.
Gee, I wonder what happened.
That makes me ill that Rachel posed like this for Frank. I wrote him love letters. I can't believe she was banging Frank. Rachel straight up lied to my face. Why didn't she say anything?
Because she knew how you would react.
And she wasn't much of a friend, huh? Just another person who shits all over me. Why does everybody in my life let me down? My dad gets killed, you bail on me for years, my mother gloms on a stepfucker, now Rachel betrays me.
Chloe, Rachel is missing. Nobody betrayed you.
Bullshit! Who hasn't? Fuck everybody! Chloe!
Chloe, you can't keep blaming me and everybody for everything wrong in your life. It's so not fair.
I gotta blame somebody, otherwise it's all my fault. Fuck that.
So now it's Rachel's fault too?
Jesus, she was banging that pig, Frank! Bitch lied to my face, Max! I can't trust anybody again. Everybody pretends to care until they don't. Even you.
Chloe Price. You better take that back. Right now.
Okay. Fine. But you just don't understand. It's like I'm being punished by the universe.
So who do you most want to blame?
My fucking dad, of course. Hello?
You blame William? Really?
Yes, I do. Damn right. He chose to go out that door and leave me forever.
Chloe, your dad didn't choose to leave you.
I know that, Max. My mom actually blames herself. Just because she wanted a ride home from work. Sometimes, even I blame her.
No, you don't.
Yes, Max, I do. Do you know what it's like to wait for your father to come home when you're a kid? And he never does?
No, of course not. But I was with you that day. It was just a terrible accident.
I wish that made me feel better. But ever since he died, my life has been dipped in shit.
You don't want to hear this, but you're still here. Alive. With me. And that is no accident.
You're right. I don't want to hear this.
Chloe, I can't do this out on my own. I need you with me. And Rachel needs you. Oh my God, what is happening now?
Someday Dad'll get one of them newfangled computers.
Whoa.
I hope the flash didn't scare you, Max. This is a keeper.
Not until I see it first. You know the rules, Dad. Max, tell him.
Whoa, hey. You look totally pale. Are you okay?
Yeah. I just... Yeah, I'm fine.
Okay, Chloe. Give me the thumbs up or thumbs down.
Well, I might just allow this one into the family album.
You're the boss.
What is this?
But not the cook?
William is here.
Daddy.
Yes,
and
we can't.
Chloe is just a kid.
And serve us slackers.
Am I that far back in time?
You mean pancakes?
In France, they call them crepes.
I'm 18 years old inside my 13-year-old self. If you want to eat. How?
We. I volunteer to break the eggs.
Do you remember how many eggs?
Mom said it depends.
That's true.
So, how many eggs?
Don't you dare question the chef.
Man. I remember Chloe reading this. But not after today.
Right, like you're the real cook here.
I know I've seen those pictures before.
I am when your mom is away.
I'll let her know.
I love William like he was in my own family. I won't let him die today. Chloe is just so damn happy and carefree. And this is the last time unless I change it.
Now I get to take a picture. Strike a pose.
Make me a star.
Just make me look young.
Yep, I missed the bird.
Hello?
That's a cool snow dough.
Just making a fabulous breakfast with Chloe and Max. We're all going to work at the Two Whales. What? Oh, I didn't know you had to get groceries. Of course I'll come pick you up. Now I'll have an excuse to get a mocha. Be there shortly. Love you.
I have to stop William from taking his car today.
Ladies, I have to go rescue yonder queen at the Save Mart. She doth have many bags of delicious grub for us to feast upon.
You are ridiculous.
You'll be grateful for that someday. Shit, where are my keys?
That's a dollar for the swear jar.
You mean your college fund. Keys, please.
Obvious, but it will have to do.
You can't hide from me forever. Now lock up after I leave. Play nice. Try not to destroy too much of the house.
No.
And no Chloe and Max wine tasting session.
Dad!
Don't blow it, because tonight your mother promised to make us a world-famous salmon surprise with chocolate cake for dessert. Max, you'll be here too, right?
She's never leaving me.
That makes all of us.
Aww. Oh, rewind!
You'll be grateful for that someday. Shit, where are my keys?
That's a dollar for the swear jar!
Score!
You mean your college fund. Keys, please.
They'll never find the keys because I have them.
I know they never took that big vacation.
Hide the keys.
Shit, where are those keys?
Another dollar for the swear jar!
Chloe was so into manga. Nice hair.
You're bankrupting me!
No!
I knew this thing would come in handy. How the hell did my keys end up here? And no, Chloe.
No! Rewind!
He'll be great.
All the way back.
Do you remember how many eggs?
Mom said it depends.
Boom.
That's true.
Disconnected.
Uh-huh. How many eggs?
Don't you dare question the chef.
Right. Yes. Here's the two whales number. Now I can warn Joyce.
Hey, like you're the real cook here?
I am, when your mom is...
Now I get to take a picture.
I'll let her know that.
Aha, see? No one's calling.
Listen, don't let your dad take his car today. I know it sounds weird, but please believe me. Something terrible is going to happen. You have to stop him from driving anywhere.
Whatever, weirdo. What kind of thing is that to say about my dad?
I'm not joking.
Then you stop him, Supermax.
Well, I unplugged the phone. That should do it, right? Cell phone.
Hey, honey. I have no idea why the home phone didn't ring just now. I'm just making a fabulous breakfast with Chloe and Max. We're all going to work at the Two Whales. What? Oh, I didn't know you had to get groceries. Of course I'll come pick you up. Now I'll have an excuse to get a mocha. Be there shortly.
Well, put the keys in here. You can't do the beepy thing.
Excuse me, ladies. I have to go rescue Whoa. Yonder queen at the Save Mart. She doth have many bags of deli... I know I had those keys right here. I know it. Forgot all about you, little buddy. Release the keys. Of course. Last time I ordered from Spy Guy Electronics.
You can take the bus, right? The stop is right down the street.
This I can do. Good call, Max.
Oh yeah, the bus is great. It comes every 15 minutes and there'll be plenty of room for you and Joyce and groceries and it'll save the environment.
Okay.
You sold me already. I'm off to yonder bus stop. Joyce will love this.
Max, you are being so fucking strange. You feel okay?
Chloe, I am awesome. We are awesome.
Oh, we actually saved him. Step douche.
Hello, are you even listening, Maxine?
All my friends in LA told me that Oregon was
Max.
Wet and cold every day.
But never, like Maxine.
So that's why she was laughing so hard.
I know, sorry, Mad Max. You're not pissed at me, right? Right? Do you want to go hit the girls' potty and smoke them peace pipe?
I think Max is high.
She's acting like so weird. You cool, Max?
Nobody listened when I said we shouldn't let her in the vortex.
Courtney, you don't want anybody in the club.
Like, whatever, bitch.
Warren, he hooked up with Stella? Oh no, this is totally fucked up. What else have I changed? Chloe.
More good music.
Max Caulfield. Taking a break after taking Seattle by storm, huh?
He's alive.
We thought we'd never see you again after you left for the big city.
No. I'd never do that to Chloe.
Speaking of, I know she's been dying to see you. Hold on. Chloe! You have a visitor!
So yeah, that was episode 3. He saved William, but it seems like other things happened too. So yeah, imagine seeing that ending and having to wait 4 months until the next episode came out. Yeah. Stealing the money. Major majority for kissing Chloe. Major majority for siding with Chloe. Major majority from not getting the dog hurt, which I don't see how anyone can do that, but... And Chloe has David's gun. 69%. You killed Lisa, like 62% of the people. You didn't help Warren with his exam, change his grade. You're on the Vortex Club party list, although technically you didn't have to edit it, because you already did that last episode. You didn't erase any names from the party list. You erased the cop's answer phone message. You helped Alyssa, like 70% of people. You warned the homeless woman. Oh, you're in a minority for that one. You took a photo in the past, and, oh, I guess I rewound and I didn't leave a mark on the fireplace. Oops. I tried. We don't know. You'll have to watch or, you know, do the next episode. We'll be right back. Episode 4, The Dark Room. So yeah, it's strange, huh? kind of really makes you want to do the fourth episode, doesn't it? But, I mean, I don't know if I can stream again until after I get back from Boston. I don't know if I can do it tomorrow night, or Thursday, or Friday, or Saturday. I don't know. You might just have to wait like a full week and a half until I get back. I could torture you like that. Or, you know, the game is on sale on Steam this week, so you could buy the game and play through it. And make all your own choices about everything, but, you know. Alright, well, thanks for watching. Chat after I go off.